Honiara set for a high-level delegation from China. The Solomon Islands Prime Minister calling the upcoming visit a milestone. In a statement, the government saying, Prime Minister Sogavare looks forward to a productive engagement with the People's Republic of China as an important development partner at a very critical time in our history. Foreign Minister Wang Yi and more than a dozen other Chinese diplomats will also visit Papua New Guinea and six other Pacific nations, bolstering China's presence in the region.
But it isn't the end of the road. Australia still has a number of options here to respectfully, collegially continue to engage with its neighbours in the Pacific and also respectfully engage with China. There is undoubtedly competition at work here. But competition in and of itself is not necessarily an unhealthy thing.
Canberra will be keeping a close eye on Beijing's trip abroad, as the new foreign minister reiterated Australia's commitments to its Pacific neighbours.
We want to help build a stronger Pacific family. That is why we will do more. But we will also do it better. We will listen because we care what the Pacific has to say.
Last night, the Chinese Foreign Ministry offering what appeared to be an olive branch, recalling when the Whitlam-led Labor government established landmark diplomatic relations with China in
1971.
Paving the way for a potential relationship reset.
It's a bit of an opening of the freezer door, if you like. And there is an opportunity here for Australia to explore around the margins a way of improving relations with China.
A rapprochement that would be welcomed by the Chinese-Australian community.
It's not going to happen overnight, but we are hopeful that at least if it is not as negative as it has been over the years, things will start to improve eventually, but it will take time.
It's the first time since 2020 that any official diplomatic dialogue has taken place between China and Australia. Rochelle Harrison-Pless, SBS World News.